Hello everyone, in this video we have one square and here is 15 and this length is given 18 and then this angle is given 45 degrees and this evaluated area is asked. Okay, first of all let's call here alpha and here theta. We know that alpha plus theta equal 45 degrees, right? Okay. And then, if we take the tangent both sides of the equation, we know that tangent 45 degrees equals 1, right? And then, we know that the expansion of tangent alpha plus theta equal tangent alpha plus tangent theta over 1 minus tangent alpha times tangent theta equal 1, right? So, if we organize the equations, tangent alpha plus tangent theta plus tangent alpha times tangent theta equal 1. And then, I want to represent with the length of the AE with A. So here must be 18 minus A, right? And then let's call here B. That means here must be 18 minus B. And we know that the length of the DC equals 18 units. Notice that tangent alpha equal A over 18 plus tangent theta equal B over 8, right? And then let's go 8 plus 8 times B over 18 squared equals 1. And then if we organize the equation, A plus B over 18 plus 8 times B over 18 squared equals 1. So if we multiply with 18, numerator and denominator, 18a plus 18b plus a times b equals 18 squared. Okay, this is the first equation. And then for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, 18 minus a whole squared plus 18 minus b whole squared equals 15 squared, right? And then 18 squared minus 36a plus a squared plus 18 squared minus 36b plus b squared equals 15 squared. Okay. And then notice that 18 squared plus 18 squared equals 2 times 18 squared minus 36a minus 36b plus a squared plus b squared equals 15 squared. Okay. And then, if you multiply with 2, both sides of this equation, 36a plus 36b plus 2 times ab equals 2 times 18 squared, right? And then, if you plug in this value, instead of 2 times 18 squared, 36a plus 36b plus 2 times ab minus 36a minus 36b plus a squared plus b squared equals 15 squared. And then these are again. Notice that a squared plus b squared plus 2ab equals perfect squared, right? That means a plus b whole squared equals 15 squared. So a plus b equals 15 units. Okay. And then let's plug in this value to this equation. 18 times a plus b plus ab equals 18 squared. So we know that a plus b equals 15, right? plus AB equals 18 times 18. That means AB equals 18 times in parentheses 18 minus 15. Therefore, A times B equal 54 units. And now we know that A plus B equals 15. So A must be equal, yes, right here, AB, and here is area. If A equal 6, therefore B must be equal 9. This is the first case. And second case, if A equal 9, that means B equal 6. Okay. Now we can calculate the area very easily, right? Let me clear here. And first case, if here is 6 and here is 9, notice that if ratio of these two sides equal 30, that means hypotenuse must be 6 root 10. And then if ratio of these two sides equal 2, that means hypotenuse must be equal 9 root 5. So the blue shaded area equal, if we use sine formula, 6 root 10 times 9 root 5 over 2 times sine 45 equals root 2 over 2. That means blue shaded area must be equal, let's simplify the expression, 135 unit square. Okay, this is the first case. Now let's calculate the second case. Second case, if A equal 9, that means B must be equal 6, right? So let's hear 9 and 6. That means hypotenuse must be equal 9 root 5 and 6 root 10. Okay. Notice that these two sides and angle equal to first case, right? That means the area must be equal same. Okay. This was a long way. Now we will calculate the blue shaded area using short way. Okay. Let's call here alpha and theta again. We know that alpha plus theta must be equal 45 degrees, right? Okay. And then second step. If we take here alpha degrees like this, and then let's extend this corner. I want to represent this point with K, and notice that here this angle must be 90 minus alpha, and then here is also 90 minus alpha. That means these two triangles are congruent, right? Why? Because they have same sides and angles. Okay. That means ADE triangle and CDK triangle are congruent. Okay. We know that congruent triangles have same sides and angles. Therefore, if there is this length opposite of the 90 degrees, that means opposite of the 90 degrees must be equal same length. Okay. And then this side is common side. Notice that this triangle and this triangle are congruent, right? Because they have same two sides and angles, which between these two equal sides. Therefore, these two triangles are congruent. So, ADF triangle and KDF triangle are congruent. Okay. And then we know that congruent triangles have same sides and angles. That means if there's a 50 in opposite of the 45 degrees, here must be equal 15 units, right? So the length of the DC must be equal 18 because of square. So the blue shaded area equal the area of KDF triangle. And then KDF triangle area equal 18 times 15 over 2. That means blue shaded area equal 135 unit square. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.